Around Christmas time, supplies were running low around the house, and I needed to make a trip to the store to get a few things to keep us going. I grabbed the envelope that we usually keep the cash in for this kind of thing, and I headed out the door. My two-year-old went with me. We walked around Walmart and grabbed all the things we needed and a few extras along the way. Prunes for the constipated baby, protein bars for breakfast, and I can't remember what else. We made our way to the self-checkout area, and I rang everything up. The total came to about 50 bucks and some change. I pulled out the envelope I brought with me, ready to pay, but only $20 was inside, and I had left my wallet at home. I turned to the lady in charge of the self-checkout area, and I explained to her the situation. I asked her if I could leave my cart somewhere, go home, grab my wallet, and then come back and pay for everything. She was fine with that. Then a man I had never met before, who had been listening to me explain all this to the checkout attendant, came up to me and said, "How much do you need?" "Quite a lot," I said. I really thought there was money in here, but I'm about $30 short. "I can help you out," he said. And then he opened his wallet and handed me $30 cash. "Does that help?" he asked. In my head, I thought, "I don't need this. I just didn't bring enough money with me. My kids are getting plenty of presents this year, and we're going to be eating enough food over the course of the next couple of days to allow us to hibernate for the rest of the winter." But all I could say was, "Yes, thank you," because I was blown away by this man's kindness. I didn't even think to say, "I'll pay it forward," or something like that. I've reflected on this small act of kindness almost every single day since it happened. I thought about it on Christmas Eve and Christmas morning. I thought about it on New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. It was the best gift I received this year because it totally changed my perspective. You see, last year I worked pretty damn hard. Some days I worked from 7 a.m. to 3 a.m. without stopping. I met every deadline along the way, and I developed a healthy sense of pride. I woke up at 5 a.m. to work out, meditate, read, review my goals, etc. All the stuff you're supposed to do if you want a successful life. It paid off. I had success. I achieved goals. I made my life and my family's life so much better. But in some way, my heart also hardened. I started to view myself as 100% self-reliant. And while that can be a useful idea in terms of personal responsibility, it's just not true. No matter how disciplined, resilient, or otherwise badass we become, we still need the kindness of others to succeed in life. And we still need to show kindness to others, even perfect strangers. As I reflect again on this experience, I can't help but feel an overwhelming sense of gratitude towards the man who gave me that $30 I just did not need. I didn't deserve it. I didn't ask for it. It was completely my fault I had left my wallet at home. But thanks to this man, I can now see that the decision to show kindness to someone else in need, regardless of how their need was created, is always the right one. And by writing about this experience, I hope I'm paying it forward. Written by Josiah Rosenberger. Josiah has ghostwritten 35 personal development books and counting. When he's not writing, he's reading. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And I hope Josiah, when he hears it, he enjoys it also. How do you pay it forward? Thanks for listening. See you tomorrow.